今年37岁的 Paul 就职于瑞士跨国企业史陶比尔集团，担任流体连接器供应链中国区总负责人。自2013年的一次公司外派到浙江杭州开始，直至2017年再次定居，他与中国结下了不解之缘。
So I joined Stobi, and after 2 years, more or less, they told me that, okay, Paul, it's going well, and we remember that you said that you wanted to travel abroad, and we have in the group, and we have another factory based in China, in Hangzhou. So we would like you to go, because well, there's a strong partnership, and to go there and to see how we can improve our collaboration, and anything like that. So that's when the first time I came to Hangzhou was in June 2013. And it was an amazing experience.
来到中国之后，这里的情景与 Paul 想象中的相去甚远，而杭州人民对于远方来客的热情更是让他大吃一惊。
People are really welcoming. Really welcoming when, like, so the first time I came, so 2013, so, yeah, 12 years, yeah, 11 years ago, so of course, changed things a lot, and the same, but I remember, so I went to Chirou, of course, to Westlake for the first time, and at that time, like, every 10 meters, people were stopping me to take pictures with me. and at the beginning, I was wondering, but if I saw it was,curiosity, but a good curiosity. You know, sometimes like curiosity can be, what is a foreigner doing here? I don't know, here it was really just good curiosity, and yeah, like China opening and the opportunity to share what they know with foreigners. So also this is the welcoming part of Chinese people.
在中国生活的时间里， Paul 也逐渐了解并爱上了中国的文化。对于他来说，中国的城市和文化都充满着吸引力。从最早的法国时翻阅有关中国的相册，到阅读中国科幻与观看时下热播的电视剧，成了他了解中国的方式。在他看来，不同国家的科幻小说背后隐藏着各自的历史与文化，《三体》更是成了他爱不释手的书籍。读万卷书时， Paul 也没有忘记行万里路。11年来，他的足迹遍布各大城市，从飘雪的哈尔滨冰雪大世界，到热辣滚烫的山城重庆，再到山水甲天下的桂林。在中国扎下根后， Paul 的家人朋友们也加入了他的中国旅行团。
My mom came to visit, so it was in 2019. Yeah, it was in 2019. And she came to visit with 7 friends. So totally 8 people that I had to take care of. So, but the deal, like, because I took 2 weeks holiday, but the deal with my mom that, okay, I take care of you the first week, but then enough and I take 1 week holiday.So with my mom, so we went to Shanghai, went to Hangzhou, and we went to Guilin. I bring my family. We first go to Linding Temple, and then we can walk in the park, and then we arrive at Longjing. And then after, they went by themselves to Xi'an and Beijing. And it was really interesting also seeing, like, understand another part of Chinese culture, and yeah, just bought a souvenir in order, like, to still remember that time.
在 Paul 的坚持与努力下，对于他的家人们来说，中国不再是一个遥不可及的东方符号，而是切实接触到的美丽国家。现如今，他未来在中国生活和发展的计划也得到了家人们的认可和支持。
Already before I came to live in China, she already visited China. So she already knew it was an amazing country, and so it was already good. And then, no, no, they totally support me because they know that I'm happy here. And that's all that matters to them.
在家人和朋友们眼中， Paul 显然成了与中国文化之间的一道桥梁。对于他来说，交流是一个双向的过程，在为身边人带来中国文化时，也将法国的文化带到了中国。
It's so important also because it's hard for people to imagine China. So even if I talk a lot to my family, I describe my experience, I send some photo, even when they came here, they didn't expect that. French people can come to visit China for 2 weeks, and this is, of course, it's really helpful. I'm lucky because I have Chinese friends,foreigner friends. It's a real opportunity to have people from all over the world and to discuss and to share culture. And so I really hope that this year more of my friends will come. I will really push them and also like to come and visit me and to know more about China and to see how impressive China is.